Hi everyone, it's Tammy, and I know you wanted to see some more nail videos, so I'm going to do a nail video today that I'm going to try to do like a Lilly Pulitzer design on my accent nail. So the first thing I'm going to do is I just take this Nail Envy, and I know this still has some silver on it from the last, well, actually it's a couple manicures ago, because my nail broke and I put on some super glue and I can't get the bad stuff off. So, I mean, it works, but it's sticky. And this kind of has some really deep dark purple around the edges because I couldn't remove it all. So, you know, I'm real life. This is how I would do it, even though not all of the polish is totally off. And someone gave me a really good hint to get the polish off the sides of your nails, to use an eyeshadow brush. I need to do that. I did not get one for this time, but I'm going to try to remember to put one in my bag. I'm trying to hurry a little bit because my daughter has a friend coming over at 1 and I want to meet him. They're going to go on a date and I want to meet him. So I am trying to hurry, and it is 12:18 right now, so I don't know if I'm going to get this done before he gets here, but I'm going to try. So I just put my bottom coat of Nail Envy on because that is my favorite bottom coat. I need to do a favorites video, and that would definitely be in it. So this is what it looks like. And then I'm going to do, I think, a background of this mint. This is Shell Me More by Paparazzi, and I get this at CVS, and it is 2 for $5, so it's not very expensive. And someone else said that if you do this in 3 swipes, it's really good to do that that way, but clearly I'm not very good at that. So, and she said to be really careful about getting the bottom and the edges, so I'm trying not to go all the way down there, but I don't know how you'd do it in 3 swipes. I'm sure that that's how they do it, but I am not good at that. That was a little better, but yeah. I'll just be me. Practice, 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 but I'm like kind of shaking. I take this medicine and I think that it makes me a little shaky because I just took it. It's for my blood pressure. Getting old stinks, guys. I tell my husband it's him because I never was on it before I met him, so it has to be him, right? That sounds like a good conclusion. Do you guys know Lilly Pulitzer? She does some planners. I've actually been very tempted to buy her planner, but I did buy one. I bought one for my daughter. I did a walkthrough. I don't know. I'll try to see if I can find the video, and if I can remember, I'll post it below so that you can see what the Lilly Pulitzer planner looks like. It is really cute. I love it. I love her like watercolor like kind of look. So hopefully this is going to do it a little bit of justice. I'm sure it's not going to be anything nearly as good as hers, but you know, we just do the best we can, right? This one I got a little thick. I'm glad that I'm not going to be painting on that one. If I get the base coat down, that'll be a good start. What a dingbatty thing to say. Of course that's the good start. I'm just thinking about time is what where my head is right now, in case you guys are wondering what the heck I'm talking about. Because I want to be downstairs before he arrives so that I can meet and greet him. And they're going to a movie. And then they're actually going to go to his parents' house to have dinner. Kitty's really kind of sweet like that. And And parents seem to like her, so that's always fun for her. She likes older people. So I'm getting it on myself. I can see it. Maybe what I'll do is I will, after I've showed you guys, maybe I'll clean it up with an eyeshadow brush and then take pictures of it later, because clearly I'm going to need to clean up my sides, because lordy be. I can usually clean them up in the shower, which is fine, but I took a shower today, so I won't need one for another week and a half or 2 weeks. Just kidding. Okay, so we got the base coat on all of them. I did two coats of this pretty green. And then I need to have some different shades of pink for the flower design I'm going to do. And I think I'm going to use this paparazzi. It's called Pageant Girl, for the main part of the flower, and maybe even do an accent nail in this and then do it here too. And I have a hair in my mouth. And then I have, oh, you know what I forgot to get was my top coat. Then I have like a green color and a white color and lighter pink colors. Are these the same colors? This is so cheeky and this is super spun or sugar spun. So no, they are not the same color. And I have this glittery greenish color. Pure Ice nail polish. I have no idea where this came from. Watch Me Go, I think is the name of the color. It's kind of a bluish green. I don't know if I want to use that for leaves or not. And then I think I'll use these. And then I have this gray that I might incorporate somehow. This is Petal Pushers by Essie. So, okay. Oh, and then I also have white from Julep, and it looks like I have white from, this is Icing on the Cake from Paparazzi. I just got out a bunch of my colors. This is a light pink Fifi by Julep. And then I have a kind of a goldish color called Judy in Boho Glam by Julep. I don't know what collection this is in, if it tells you. Oh, I think the collection is Fifi, and It's a Girl is the color. And then I also have my little paint markery thing, so I should be set. I hope. So, and I have, like a little hair in my mouth. Yuck. Okay, now I'm kind of wondering, well, am I committed? Where's a little pokey thing? Here it is. Am I committed? Let's try this real quick. Let's see. If I put this down. See, I was afraid of that. It's going to be really light. So maybe I will put a lighter color down first. And then go around it in a darkery pink color. And I'll just roll this through all the nail polish because that's the way I roll. Oh, I didn't shake it. Oh, come on, pink. Wow, it's coming. I'm seeing it. It's a coming. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. You can see it in there, right? Ah, it's starting to come out. Okay. Okay, so yes, I think I'll do that. And then here's this green color that I should go ahead and open up too. And I wonder if this white is opened up. Okay, the white is opened. I'll do the green. I don't think I need the red. I can put the red away. Oh, come on. Oh no. Trying to be goofy and I'm knocking everything over. Oh my goodness, this is killing me, Smalls. I can see it. Oh, there it is. I guess that's good. Okay, so I'm going to start by putting little flowers of this on my nail, and I think I will use, I don't know if I want to use this brush. Yeah, that might be okay. Just take most of the paint off. Now, I have never drawn these flowers before, so who knows what we're going to get into. But I figure it can't be too hard, because I've seen a lot of people do it. And I've watched some videos on how to do it. Okay, so hopefully you guys can see the the pink polka dots that I have on here. They're very rough, nothing special. I'm just gonna let that dry for a second, and while that's drying, I'm gonna take a drink. I have one of those baby 7.5 ounces of Diet Pepsi. It's kind of cute. And it's just a perfect amount sometimes, because sometimes I don't need a big ol' amount of pop. Yeah, this one isn't as prominent as that one. Oh, and I just touched it. That's lovely. Oh well. I'm going to use the pink next, if I can pick it up. And then for this one, you just kind of use it and go on the outside and put like little C's. I just messed up that nail. And it's probably not dry enough yet. You want to put like little C's around the outside of the nail, but not like a full C, just kind of like a little line around the outside of the flower. Kind of like that, and then you'll do the same thing on the inside. And I'm just going to try to like touch it to my nail because it's not really dry yet. I don't know, this might just look like a hot mess. I don't know that that looks like a rose or a flower or anything but a mess. Goodness, and I'm messing up this nail. Lordy B. I should probably put that top coat on the ones that I think are dry or are, you know, done. So this color is pretty, but it's kind of hard to paint, I have to say, because it seems like it is easily messed up and it doesn't dry very quickly. So those two combinations is not fantastic. And I'm not the world's best painter, so that doesn't help. And I didn't get out my little dot thing, so I can't really do that. I might actually have to call my daughter in to help me get those little dot things, or the drop things to make your nails. Okay, I'm going to attempt to do the little C things here. The drop things to make your nails dry fast. That's what I'm talking about. So I'm just kind of dotting this because I stink at doing things with my left hand. So I'm just trying to put some on the inside and on the outside to kind of make it look like a rose. At least that's my goal. And I used the 3 because that usually is a good number for your eyes, but then I'm doing the inside too, so I don't really know. I don't know. I'm just doing what I think I can do. So then let's go on the outside, or let's go around with a little bit of white. Just to help brighten it up a little. I can't tell if that's coming out or not. Oh yeah, there now it is. I don't know what I'm doing here. And then I think what I'm going to do is take a little bit of that glitter pink, because I like that, and go over the flower maybe. Just with a little. Drop of glitter pink. I feel like I'm doing really good on time. It's been 18 minutes, I guess, so that's not too awfully bad. Now I think I'm going to take some green. I wonder, I don't think this is too close in color. And I'm going to make like little leaves. I don't even know if you can see those very well. I almost wish I had another color green. Let's see how this does. I put just a little touch of it next to each flower. That's kind of cute. That's a big glop. Okay. I think that's kind of cute. I kind of like it. What do you guys think? Can you tell it's flowers? I'm like so shaky, sorry. Now I might do like a pink on this color or on this hand. That actually kind of even made it polish go on a little better, so maybe when I do the top coat the polish will look a little better. I don't know if I like that pink on there, but it's not horrible. I can go with it. And someone said that if you apply this with a sponge or something, like if you apply the glitter, maybe not glitter polish, I think it was like glitter, that it goes on a lot better. Yeah, I think that was glitter, so never mind. Don't do that with the polish. You'd probably cause a big mess. So I clearly have it all over the outsides of my hands as I just painted on my skin once again. I don't like how the glitter like kind of stays in one spot. I don't know why it does that. Okay, I'm going to call it done before I mess them up, but yeah, I kind of like it. Alright, so let me put on a clear coat. I'm going to use the Sally Hansen Big Shiny Top Coat. Okay, this color, I'm giving it a little better score now that I colored over it with a shiny cut or with a top coat, because it does kind of smooth out a little with the top coat, which is nice. I'll have to search the videos that I watched, and they weren't nail videos. I don't think I watched any done on somebody's nails. One I know was done on a phone case. That was really cool. She's the one that made me think, oh, I wonder if I could do that on my fingernails. Okay, I'm kind of afraid to do it on these, but let's see what happens. Okay, I think enough time has dried for that one anyway. So I will clean up this mess and then I will do some more video with my nails after they've dried and I've cleaned up the sides. I think I've got some glob on there. I know there's some glob on there. Ooh-wee. Okay. So I hope you guys like it, because I think it's kind of cute. I kind of like it. Okay, I will clean this up and then I will be back to show you. Thanks so much for watching. Bye. Okay, I'm back, guys. I did take the polish off of the sides of my hands, and then you'll also, or the sides of my nails, you'll also notice that I took it off these middle fingers because I just didn't like the way it was looking. So, and I'll tell you what, this nail polish is really, really, did I say really? Because it's really, really hard to get off. So, whoo-wee, that glitter nail polish. I'm going to go ahead and start again with a coat of this Nail Envy. But I really like how the flowers turned out. I really think that they turned out really cute. And I took some pictures with the way I had the glitter, and I'll probably include those here at the end, or maybe in even the beginning, I don't know. But I just really decided that I didn't like the way that the pink looked over the green. I should have just done pink. So that's what I'm gonna do now, just pink glitter on this finger. So I put the Nail Envy on and I let that dry for a little minute. Goodness. I don't know if I screwed that on straight. Yeah, I think I did. It's just hard to get on. Okay, let's see. I don't need the green anymore. I'm gonna make sure I have all these pretty tight. I don't need this, don't need this. Don't need this, or this. Or this, and I didn't even use a gray. I've purchased lots of grays recently and I haven't used any of them yet, but I will. And I'm going to use a pink. This one kind of has a little bit of glitter to it, a little sparkle. So Cheeky, it's called. I think I'll use that one. And then this is my Ipsy bag from February. And I love it, and it holds those little nail pins nicely, and I just love this bag. So okay, so now that I have that on there, I'm going to put this Sally Hansen the big peel off base coat. Honestly, I haven't seen much of a difference with this, with using it or not, but I'm just, it's so difficult to get that glitter nail polish off. I want to go ahead and use it. Because even if it's just a little bit of protection or makes it a little bit easier, it's better than nothing, because literally I feel like I'm ripping my fingernail off trying to get that nail polish off. And then, I don't know, I'm afraid I'm going to break it because I'm like pushing so hard to get that off. Now the only problem with this is that you have to let it dry, so it takes about 5 minutes. So you can literally sit here and watch paint dry, as one of my subscribers said once. Or I could pause it and get back, but I think that's what I'll do so you guys don't have to literally watch paint dry. I will be right back. Okay, so the paint has dried and I'm going to put on a coat of this lighter pink first. Yeah, that's kind of pretty. It's a little sparkly in itself. But it's just a very, very light pink. I still have some green on this one. Oh well. No one will notice on a galloping horse. That's what my grandma used to always say. And I will put on. Oh, please come off easily. Please come off easily. Please come off easily. I know it won't, but I'm talking to it anyway. See, I want it to be like a full coat of glitter. I don't like that at all. So I guess I will wait and see if it dries nicely, and then I can put another coat on there. That's not the look I'm looking for. I want like a nail of glitter. I have this stuff, but I don't really want to use that. I wonder if I just use like crafting glitter. Maybe another coat will do it though. Let's see. Yeah, see, that's not really the look I'm looking for. You guys know what I'm talking about, don't you? Like when your nail is just full of glitter. I've done it before, but not with this, I guess, and this is just not exactly the look I'm looking for. What if I'm going to do something that I probably shouldn't do, and I will probably regret it. I'm even going to use a card that I've made. And here we go. Now that might be a little thick. Do I have that little thing still out and about? What did I do with it? Oh, I put it back. I'm just trying to take off the excess around the edges because it is kind of thick. But I kind of like it. What do you guys think? It's more the look I was looking for. This is just craft glitter, which I'm sure 18 billion people would say this is not the right thing to use. But you know what? Sometimes I just want it to look the way I have it envisioned in my head. Okay, so it looks like I put a coat of that pink on here, but you really can't even see it. It is such a light pink. So let's put another... Or let's put the first coat of this glitter on here. I might just do one coat of this glitter since it's so hard to take off anyway. And since I'm covering it up with this. I'm just pushing it in there with my finger. I didn't quite do that with this one. I used a napkin, which I think did the trick too. It just might have made it a little thicker than this is doing. Now I'll do the same thing around this one if I can without messing it up too badly. Since it's my left hand. Okay, I think that did the trick. Now, let's see. Let's put this back in here. Put the card back over here. Put the lid on here before I spill it. Okay, now I'm going to take this big top, big shiny top coat, and I think I'm just going to kind of goodness, I think I might just like dab it on a little bit, like start it with a big glop. And then try to spread that glop around. Glop is the technical term. If you guys haven't used that before, you probably should. I actually did a pretty good job with one big glop. So let's try it with this one. So I use a big glop, let it glop on there, and then kind of spread that out. And I will put another coat on. And I'm actually going to put another coat on this one too, because I actually really like that flower that I did, or the flowers that I did. I think it really does kind of look like a Lilly Pulitzer, and I've impressed myself. Sorry if that sounds conceited. I don't want it to be, but I'm proud of myself for doing it. I think it's pretty cute. Already got something on this nail. Oh well, I'm not gonna worry about it. My thumbnails are kind of short. They both broke, so I had to trim them a little. My right hand, or no, my left hand was getting a little out of control with the length, so I had to trim a lot of those. My left hand seems to grow longer than my right hand, probably because I am right-handed and use it so much. So I'm just going to put another coat on this one. And I even think that I did a pretty good job with my left hand. I have to say, I'm kind of impressed with myself. I might, in a couple of days, need to do another coat of that green, but that's okay. Okay, I think that's the look I was looking for. I really kind of like it. I hope that you guys do too. Let me put something white under here, maybe if I can find something. Here's my iPad. It's kind of white. So there, yeah. I really like these. These might be my favorites so far. So let me know what you think, and I hope that you try it. It's really not as hard as it looks. If I can do it, you can do it. And if I did this glitter thing wrong, don't tell me, because I kind of like the way it looks, and maybe I'll even use it again. Okay, thanks everybody. I'll talk to you soon. Bye!